stepping into the world of intellectual freedom and unscripted ideation. You're listening to the Unstructured Pod with the Wizards of Wonder, Jawan Farah
and Ethan Zaretsky. Get ready to break free from the confines of conventional thinking.
Season 2 of the Unstructured Podcast. One of us live in Antarctica. The other one literally knows how to dress. We are here with a very special guest, Jess Gordon. Literally does everything and anything here at Penn State. How the hell are we feeling?
Good. How are you guys doing today?
Doing great. I don't know why Jawan decided he had to chirp me about what I'm wearing when his team isn't even in the playoffs. But we're not going to talk about hockey because we do that every single episode. So, Jess, how are you doing today?
I'm doing good. The vibes are good today. You know, it's super sunny out, super nice out. So I think today is a good day.
What'd you eat for breakfast?
I always ask this. Literally every...
What'd you eat for lunch?
Okay,
lunch was not that exciting. It was literally just ground beef and rice mixed together.
Literally getting so jacked, it's actually scaring me.
Okay.
Ground beef is literally the bulking meal,
yeah,
is it
ground
not?
Beef is just, I feel like it's the easiest to cook because I'm not very good at cooking chicken, so.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Like
Jawan
roasted chicken?
Jawan does not
yes,
cook chicken.
See, now I don't know how to do anything. Yep.
he cooks oh, it. He cooks it until it is completely brown. And,
oh, gosh.
I was going to go live tonight again because I'm trying to do weekly IG live cooking sessions, but I don't think it's going to happen today, unfortunately, so you won't be able to see what I'm cooking. But
dang, are you scared of, like, undercooking your chicken?
Oh, no, because I've burnt my chicken all the time.
Oh.
You burn it so it doesn't get
undercooked.
Yeah,
I've already had the fire alarm go off, like, multiple
you
times.
Wanna, like,
oh, wow.
Yeah, not good. but, yeah, no, so we had a good breakfast, good lunch for Jess.
Yeah.
Jess, so being a townie, maybe talk a little bit about your experience as a Penn State student, what that's like.
Yeah, that is a very commonly asked question as a townie.
Okay, well, I don't like commonly asked questions, so on to...
No, it's... Okay, we don't have to talk about
it. No, go ahead.
I was going to say, it's kind of fun because, like, whenever I was growing up and in high school and everything, we would do the things that the college kids do now. So we would go to the student section for football games. Like, obviously, I've been going to Penn State games since I was a little one. And then tailgating, I've always done that. Like, the homecoming parade, always did that, like, growing up. And then...
What was your favorite costume back then that you ever wore for Halloween?
For Halloween. It's like, what kind of I actually one time was spaghetti and meatballs with my sister.
Who was spaghetti? Who was the meatball?
No, we were both spaghetti and meatballs. We wore like a colander on our head, like, you know, for pasta.
Like from Wegmans or Trader Joe's?
No, like a colander. Like the...
Yeah, the bowl. From Wegmans or Trader Joe's?
From Walmart.
No, yeah, like from a plastic one.
Okay, I don't know if you had a preferred like shopping store, that's all.
No, well, I like Walmart, preferably. Okay. Yeah, and then yarn on it, and then like little, I think they were just like foam balls that were brown that looked like meatballs.
And then we wore a red shirt.
Yeah, I was going to say, did you wear
like a, what's it called, like a chef, what's it called?
I mean, I don't know. I don't know what you're thinking.
The thing that the chefs wear, like when they're
aprons?
In the kitchen. Yeah, an apron.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it was just a red shirt.
So you guys were both spaghetti and meatballs.
Yes.
Don't you think it would have been better if one was spaghetti and one was
the meatball? Shout out, Jacqueline.
Yeah, shout out to my sister.
Maybe you guys got to do it again this year.
Yeah, why not go to the gym and make content of wearing that outfit and like 6 a.m.?
Oh, yeah?
No one's there anyways, right?
No, it's actually busy. You would be surprised. Like most days, like the ROTC guys will be in there right after their like run or whatever. So it's normally busy with them. And then also just like the regular crew, it's literally the same people every single day. It's so funny.
You guys should have like a little nice little breakfast with the 6 a.m. club, eh?
Yeah, the 6 a.m. club. We're like kind of friends. Like some of them, we say hey to them.
That's cute.
Yeah.
That's nice. Yeah.
What's been like the most beneficial thing that you've seen since you've been starting to wake up so early?
Probably productivity, like getting everything done, because like when you start your day so early, then it's like you have the entire day to do whatever.
Yeah.
Facts.
Yeah. And I don't really like to do work past a certain hour.
Which
so
is what
like,
hour?
Like 6.
Guys, don't text Jess after 6 p.m. She's going to be on her self-care time after 6 p.m. That's for everybody out there in the pod.
Yeah. Like that's just to be like hanging out or doing whatever. So.
Boom.
Yeah.
Bang. I don't know. What are you most excited for after graduation? Because we're all graduating.
Yeah,
by the way,
I know.
If you didn't know.
Really sad. Definitely sad. I would say probably like new opportunities because like obviously Penn State has so many opportunities and it's super fun. But there's like so many other opportunities that are to come like whenever we graduate.
Yeah.
So I think that's... What about you guys?
I'm excited to actually learn how to cook.
Yeah, it's a long time coming.
I'm throwing you off with these comments.
Yeah,
this is unstructured.
I'm excited to not have to worry about a school assignment again.
That's true. Never again.
Like, ever again.
Literally never again.
Did you always
push it off to the last minute? That's
every
what it sounds like.
Every
okay.
Time.
Interesting.
Well, yeah, that's what I do.
Self-induced stress.
It's not really stressful when you don't care.
Woo! What a flex in a good or bad way? I don't know.
You know I don't care about a lot of things.
Facts.
So.
Yeah.
Other than Rangers.
Well, that's
like, I had to bring
it
up.
It's like the only thing I care about.
Yeah, that's
like,
true. That's
both
true.
Of you guys know this. You guys are both really good friends of mine. So. Uh-huh. Today's the regular.
Is creatine in there right now?
No. I don't put creatine in a jug gallon.
So Justin literally does it.
Okay.
Not saying that
who's
cool.
Calling me right now? Should we get them
live call?
No, it's my dad. I can't. He can't.
Wow, that's a great.
Well, I would have to answer it on the watch and then go like that, super low. Like,
yeah.
Shout out my dad though. He came up this weekend, which was really nice.
Oh yeah, how was that?
It was really great.
You go golfing? That's
good. I didn't go golfing. I'm going golfing tomorrow though.
Dude, this guy golfs so good. Much.
That's not true.
Golf?
I haven't golfed since last time.
I was golfing a little bit. I was on the White Course driving range and seven irons, 65 yarder. Not a big deal, right?
I thought it was a six iron.
A six or seven iron? I don't even know.
You told us on the.
It was six iron. Whatever. Okay. Whatever the chipping.
Pitching club wedge.
Yes,
no,
pitching
it
wedge.
Wasn't a pitching wedge. You golf?
Yeah.
You on the LGPA?
No, I'm not that good.
You're gonna be.
Is.
Why not?
She's being humble.
No, I'm not
Dang,
that
so you
good.
You like golf?
No, I just.
Like you got the shoes and everything.
You got the shoes.
Wow.
Obviously.
So she's like full decked out. Like, what are you? Are you a Titleist girl or what are you?
I am more like. Yeah, Titleist. We'll say that. I like Callaway though.
Callaway?
Yeah.
You got the full bag, full set?
No, I don't have a full set. I have hand-me-down clubs. So my mom, she
hand-me-down
just hand-me-down
clubs.
Clubs.
Dude, that's how they do it in the townies. They just pass a generator.
I have it. I have hand-me-down clubs. Actually, funny thing about the golf shoes.
Literally forgot his last semester. Sorry.
When Jess and I went golfing, we both did the same thing.
Yeah!
By the way, if you don't do this,
she coached you probably.
No.
I wasn't talking about the golf. By the way, you're not even in frame. Like,
oh, my fault.
You're a bot.
No, not you, Jawan. Yeah.
Oh, well, I can't remember. Sorry.
So, if you don't do this as a golfer, I don't know why you don't do this, but you have to wear slides and or Crocs before, and then you change into your golf shoes.
with the dogs out or without the dogs
no,
out?
No, you're obviously having socks on. That's so weird.
People that wear socks with flip-flops are very questionable.
But if you're going golfing, you're going to be wearing socks either way.
Not if you wear
so you're
going to
put socks. So you're going to... Yeah, that's still a sock. I was wearing ankle socks.
Fair. I'm just saying, like, if you have, like, the Billabongs out, you know, those type of flip-flops, shout out Billabong, brand deal.
Uh-huh.
Next.
Then you can't wear socks.
You can't wear socks. You look like an NPC.
Ethan, I think you were wearing, like, Crocs or something.
Yeah, I think you're. Dang,
she's
intentional.
I was
wearing
Crocs. Knew what you were wearing. That's crazy, eh?
And then I was wearing Bergs. So, like,
Bergs?
They're just, like,
oh, like
you slide
Jesus
in.
Sandals?
What? Yeah, Jesus sandals.
Next.
I love my Birks, but they don't leave my house, unfortunately.
The
Birks are my house shoes, and the Crocs are like my outdoor.
Oh, yeah. You got to have inside outside
have
shoes.
To.
Yeah.
Literally
Jess,
have
what's
to.
Your biggest ache in Penn State, guys?
Oh, God. I was not
you see how we're just going off? I'm getting you all
Dang,
over.
Dang. Oh, my goodness. I don't know. I feel
this
like.
This pod's going really well, so.
I know it is, because I'm catching her off guard. That's
yeah,
annoying.
You really are. You're hitting me. I feel like. Gosh, that's a really loaded question.
Can't be
I don't
shy.
Know. I feel like somebody that all their personality is drinking.
Like drinking nonstop?
Yeah.
Like, I want to get mashed up tonight. That's how I'll say it, the PG version.
Yeah, that's kind of, I feel like that's an ick for me because that's not my lifestyle. So.
Boom.
Fair.
That's why.
Get the same lifestyle. Even like getting this song beginning. You know that song by Vermeer?
Yes, but I just. Yeah.
Was that not needed?
That was very cringe.
I'm not gonna lie,
I'm gonna be honest. That was not needed.
Joanna, I feel I like know. You've been singing a lot today. You started off singing, now you're singing again.
I know. I'm just like when I walk actually to class. If you want me to be like honest,
you be singing.
Yeah, I sing outside.
Outside.
Oh, fully. Like black. Wow. Like da 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 most. Yeah, yeah. Like I'm literally like walking.
What type of music are you singing?
EDM, rap.
Oh, like, you like EDM?
Yeah.
Like who?
Martin Garrix, all of them. Martin Garrix, huh. Diplo, all of them. You name
nice.
It.
Nice.
Yeah.
Is that a bad thing?
No, it's another
no,
one.
No, that's...
Huh?
What's another one that you listen to?
Martin Garrix, Diplo, top of my head.
Diplo like...
Knock 2. Do you know Knock 2? They're like underground.
Uh-uh.
Knock 2.
Diplo like the market or...
No, not Diplo like the market, eh? get a big bag of chew. No, I don't do that. Only baseball players, eh? Go yard. Dollar Dog Night last week. Next.
Dollar Dog Night
tomorrow.
But yeah.
Center County Report. Thoughts?
When we're recording this, tomorrow is the last Dollar Dog Night. But I don't
is
know when this podcast sucks. Is going out. So.
I have a question. When was the last time you went to Dollar Dog Night?
Last Tuesday.
And how many Dulizzies did you gobble?
How many did you think that I gobbled?
Seven.
Seven?
Seven? That's so
I was
many.
I was working.
Yeah, seven.
While I was working.
That's insane. That's seven hot dogs?
It's literally fuel.
Bro.
Like, you put that on the fitness pal, like, Jess, when they're
Jess,
bulking,
how many hot dogs do you think I ate?
I think you had maybe three.
I had two.
Okay.
So, yeah, you were my
I
closer.
Also had two.
Yeah, it was
why
a good
not
amount.
Have like four or five? Maybe six.
I feel like that's a little excessive.
I mean, like, that could lead to a
he's also working.
That could lead to a calendar invite for a bathroom appointment, but other than that. I threw she like that
calendar
one.
Invite for a bathroom appointment.
Yikes! Actually,
low key, like, not may or may not say this on the air.
Do you schedule your poops or what?
May or may not.
On your Google Calendar.
That's actually. Not.
All I say is bathroom break. That's all I say.
This okay. might, that might be the clip. That might be the clip.
May or may not.
I'm just thinking like
may or
that,
may not.
That might be the clip.
Dang.
May or may not. They say you have to use the bathroom.
What day?
Like, they say you have to go number two twice a day to have good bowel movement.
I completely agree with
next.
That.
Yeah.
So what day of the week last week did you have your best bowel movement?
I don't remember, but the ghost ones are the best because then it's low.
Bro.
Low utility. You don't have to wipe.
There's no such thing as a ghost. There's no such thing as a ghost. Like, no.
A ghost poop? What do you mean? It's when you don't have to wipe, bro. It's
bro, what do you mean you don't have to wipe? This is like insane.
No. There's low utility. It's low utility that when like a ghost poop is basically for
everybody
out there.
How do you know if you need to wipe or not? It's
literally
not a
girls
thing.
Don't go poop. So
that's
well, first of
thing.
All, that's not a true. That's not true.
No, that's true.
No, it's 100%
it's not,
true.
No, it's
yeah.
not
no,
true.
It is. It's literally biologically, literally magnesium.
They don't
proven.
Go at all.
it literally.
Don't go to the bathroom.
Literally, get Bill your magnesium and your iron at Trader Joe's, and I get Frappuccino with 17 different things added to it.
Next.
Are you sound just like the no, just like every other.
Girl?
Yeah.
Wow, she's chirping, eh?
Wow.
A big chirp. What is your Starbucks order?
My Starbucks order is, it switches, honestly.
Okay,
I don't
so
really
what's
go...
the vibe today, Jess?
Well, today I made my coffee at home. I had coffee, actually, while I was driving here.
Timmy's or no?
Yeah, big
no.
Timmy's girl or what?
I didn't even know what that was until Ethan
told
me what
it was. Are you big curious? Are you big cake?
No, I actually like Stoke. It's cold brew. It's sold at Walmart.
How can you drink coffee if it's cold?
Do you not?
What?
She said cold brew. How do you drink coffee when it's cold?
Bro, what are you
that's
talking
like a normal
about?
Thing.
Coffee
cold.
Is ice normally
coffee,
cold.
Ice next. Coffee, yeah, and then you just put some ice in it, and then you put the
I'm
creamer
tripping,
in it,
I'm
mix
tripping.
It up. It's delicious.
That was bad. That one was bad.
Yeah, but go-to Starbucks would be iced caramel macchiato, maybe, or a shaken espresso.
Iced caramel macchiato? Is that like with the little like foaminess? In the...
No, it actually doesn't have foam on it. It's like espresso shot on the top and then
jeez,
cream on
so
the
you
bottom.
Got energy. That's where you get all your smiles and the energy from.
Yeah, but I don't have Starbucks every single day. So.
Well, yeah, because $7.99 doesn't, is not fun for the budget. Next.
Yeah, definitely not. So
shout out the $3 espresso shot at Rook. What the heck
Roth
is that?
Rock?
Roth Rock.
Thoughts on the Taylor Swift Kelce situation?
What my opinion on it?
Yeah, like so who do you think's the best? Who do you think's the best power couple, like celebrity wise?
Oh, that's a good one. See,
that's
a
great
question. You really saved yourself there. That was a good one.
Yeah, I'm gonna expose myself. I feel like I'm really
why
uncultured whenever it comes to celebrities. I don't really know many actors or like
the parents.
Yeah,
gotcha.
So that kind of
I got you example. Just, Tom Holland Zendaya.
Yeah, I don't even know who Tom is.
Yeah, Spider-Man.
I've never seen that.
Do you know who Lady Gaga is?
Yes.
Okay.
Who is she dating?
I have no idea.
She married?
I don't mean.
Juwan, what's your power couple?
Yeah, well, who's your power couple?
I just said it.
Okay.
I literally just said
okay.
it.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
What about you, Ethan?
Let me think.
Some player, Panarin, and his wife or something.
No. Because she's not. I'm going to say Jake Paul and Lena. What's her name?
Lena the Plug?
Yeah. No. I don't know Jake Paul's girlfriend's name. She's a Olympic
yes,
speed
the
skater.
Girl, the blonde, yes.
I don't
from
know.
Like
oh,
Czechoslovakia.
Utah.
Tu puedes tener una conversación español conmigo?
She's Swedish, buddy.
Sabu plesa, no?
That's, I don't even know. That was Franglish. I don't
Franglish.
Even know.
Franglish. We're going. Bro, we're all over the place.
By
today.
The way, if you're wondering,
yeah, we really
if,
are.
If you're wondering why I'm wearing a hood, it's because these headphones are absolutely foul. So PSU Belisario, fix your dang headsets.
What do you mean foul?
Yeah, what?
Like there's like stuff in it. I don't want
oh
touching.
Oh my god,
my head.
He's a germaphobe, guys.
Bring over some Clorox wipes and wipe them down.
I don't
yeah,
know. Where are the Clorox wipes at?
Bro, you literally have your hands with thousands of minerals and particles on it. So yo, give me that side eye again, bro. It's a plus one.
What are you saying? What does that even mean?
I know.
It's a plus one.
I don't know either.
You think I'm rizzing you up?
No, I'm rizzing you up. That's what I'm doing.
Okay.
Rizzolette hat. Jess is a little uncomfortable.
Poor Jess.
But
poor
no,
Jess.
It's
poor
fine.
Jess.
It's throwing you off.
Yeah,
that's
it's
what we do
me
here
off.
On the Unstructured Pod.
But that's
though.
Okay. I feel like spontaneity. Wait,
would you rather us ask questions like,
spontaneity.
Hey, spontaneous.
No, it's like, there's another word that's... Okay, sure. Spontaneous. I think that's good.
But what would you rather? Us be like, hey, Jess, where are you from? Tell us about your major.
No, yeah, that's so boring. I like intentional conversations, and I think that like asking what somebody's... this one's from Nashville. Me and my friends, we all got matching in Nashville.
Totally.
And then this one's from Target.
Tarjay.
Yeah.
I like the
you say it like
more.
That too, Tarjay? Nice.
Yeah, Tarjay.
Yeah, Tarjay
Rum. Yeah. So this one, all my buddies and I, when we went to Nashville, we all have the same.
Literally Nashville lit.
Top five city in the country.
Yeah,
literally.
Definitely,
you have
that's
no
definitely
culture.
A top one.
Not even close.
You need to
there's
go
like,
to
there's
walk.
Like there's
not
like four close. Or five major cities I've never been to. I can confidently say that Nashville
definitely
is
top.
Definitely top
yeah,
five.
Yeah, I would 100%
and Jess
agree
a,
with
Jess
that.
Jess is a traveler too. So.
Yes.
Jess, you travel a lot?
I try to as much as possible.
What's your favorite destination pit stop?
My favorite
specifically for dinner.
What?
Like in whatever city it is.
Oh, I would say whenever I went to Chicago, I had a deep dish pizza. I'm really into that. I like that a lot.
I still need to go to Chicago. I'm
yeah,
jealous.
Chi-town. I was there in February.
It's amazing.
For a little pit stop.
Ooh, was it chilly?
A little chilly.
A little windy.
A little Great Lakes action, eh?
Lots of snow.
Lots of snow.
In the mic, you know?
Yeah, lots of snow. My fault, eh? We're just...
You're good. It's just not, people are not going to hear what you have to say.
You're right.
Yeah,
and I want people to hear what I have to say because all we try to do here on the Unstructured Pod, here comes the hook, is inspire the next generation to through various lenses of media. Inspire the next generation through various lenses of media.
Wow.
Yeah?
That's so great.
Jess, is there anything else that you want to talk about?
How was you guys' weekend with Blue and White?
Ethan, go first.
It was great.
You were working.
I
what you were?
I was working.
I was working.
What was I working?
You told me that you just said like 5 minutes ago.
What are you doing, Juwan?
I was fixing it.
Messed it up, Juwan.
Ming.
Yikes.
Okay. Wow, Luigi.
Friday.
Or like Saturday. I was talking about Blue and White, but
Saturday. Saturday, I tailgated with my friends, which was interesting because of the wind.
Mm-hmm.
And then I spent more time with my dad, which is great. And then I watched the UFC fights with my dad, which is
literally
Max Holloway.
I watched that
too. Max Holloway, knockout of the. Or, I will walk out of this podcast.
I'm not a fan of Max Holloway. It was a great fight. That was planned. It was scripted. Justin Gaethje's the GOAT. Next, that Weili Zhang fight, the one right after, was absolutely electric. And Pereira just slept.
Try again. It's not. It's you're wrong three times.
It's Pereira.
Nope.
Okay, what is it then?
Pereira.
It's Pereira.
Pereira?
Yeah, it is Pereira.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. The fact that you just said Max Holloway is scripted. Like
it was
scripted. You're actually not educated on UFC, and that's
okay.
Why I have no comment.
That's okay.
Literally just not educated.
I'm literally going to the next UFC next. All right,
dang.
Next.
So that means that it's fixed. Okay. Yep.
Jess, what did you think of the fights?
Well, I wasn't really watching. I was at Champs, and it
VIP
was just
VIP section, too, by the way.
No, it was not the VIP
section. Yes, it was.
Section.
That's where all the VIPs sit. That's literally where they sit.
It was at, like, 5 p.m., so it was, like... Not the VIP section. Okay. But anyways, it was on the TV, so I was, like, barely watching. But
Bo Nickel's the GOAT.
He's crazy.
Talk about a GOAT.
Yeah, he's crazy.
Super spiritual, too, eh?
So, yeah.
He's literally, his name is company, he's a Bibleverse. 27:17.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Iron Sharpens Iron.
Yeah, Iron Sharpens Iron. That's one of my favorite verses.
Proverbs 27:17. He literally has that as the name of his company for his recovery. Shout out Ronan Bell, videographer, and Kassar, who's his, like, right-hand man.
Yup.
Savage. Bo Nickel literally, in his post game interview or post fight interview, he said this is out of context, but word for word, pretty much he said, when I'm 12-0, I'm gonna be fighting the champion. So like he just
manifest.
Dang, yeah.
He's a king, and he's gonna destroy everyone he fights next. So.
Adesanya's gonna be an interesting fight. He should get a ranked opponent next. We'll see what happens. Conor McGregor, June 29th. Literally book it. I don't care if the expenses don't make sense.
You going to Vegas?
Yep, June 29th, 30
minutes. Oh, that's good. That's
gotta
fun.
See Conor McGregor. MacLife. I'm kidding. I'm manifesting that. I haven't booked it yet.
Oh, dang.
We're manifesting it, though,
okay,
right?
Okay, well, that's cool.
This time tomorrow, I will literally be driving home.
Nice.
Driving home.
Have some paella before a 4 a.m., 7 a.m. flight to Dallas, Texas.
Woo.
Is there a good
Have you been to
Dallas?
Dallas before?
No, I've never been.
Oh, it's a really awesome city.
Jeez, bro, she's been everywhere. You got the passport too, and eh?
I got the passport, but I've only actually been out of the country one time. So
you just like going around the U.S.
Yeah, that's more. Well, I really want to go to all 50 states. That's like the next bucket list item that's going to happen.
You put that on the Unstructured Pod. So when is that going to end? When's like the KPI for that?
Ideally, within the next 5 years.
The fact that you knew what KPI meant literally wanted to make me do more push-ups because that fires me up. No, I'm not going to. Not on the Unstructured Pod. That's off camera because the forum's not there. Word of the day. That's my last question.
Okay, my word of the day is focus because we are almost at the end of the semester, and I think like focusing on like making the most of the next 2 weeks. Yeah, that's the word of the day. Focus.
Boom.
Next. You can ask me now.
Yeah, what's well, your word of the day, Ethan?
There you go. Just ask.
My word of the day is experience. You need experience to win the Stanley Cup final. And, yeah, the Rangers have experience. So,
like we always say, guys, we say one thing, but we
what's
do another. We said we weren't going to talk about hockey, and we talked about hockey. My word of the day is heat, because clearly Ethan is wearing that jersey, but under that there's probably a lot of armpit hair, sweat, which is okay.
There ain't no sweat. I'll take my shirt off right now.
Don't do that, bro, because I'll get excited.
Whoa! We just peaked really bad there. I'm sorry if you're
listening. That's what we got. I know Jess is probably like, this is so cringe, but it is what it is. Unstructured Pod, we out. Jess Gordon literally going to be on the face of Snapchat in about 6 years with her content. And that's what we got on Unstructured Pod.